first time here, and second bass of the day. I actually caught this on the hot dog using a Carolina rig, so a small circle hook from the Corrada. But look what came out of its mouth. It jumped, and a bluegill shot out of its mouth. This bluegill right here. I mean, think about it. We're using crankbaits and stuff. The exact color. See that? Bluegill was straight in that bass mouth, and it just shot out. So, you know, keep this hook out. That bluegill, just like that, and just shot out its mouth, and I jumped in the water and got it. I'm the fifth, like right on it. Like get real close.
Did it just swim off of that bluegill?
Yeah. First cast of the new pond. Got a nice little bullhead cat right here.
Hey, your bait didn't get out.
Circle hook right in the corner of the mouth.
Yeah.
Pop this out. Nice look at it. Second bullhead. Trying to get Eric's rod rigged up.
First Eric?
Guy. One piece of sausage, two catfish.
You need to get my name right, John.
I said Richard, huh?
You said Eric, huh?
Oh, barb got my finger.
Oh, damn.
This is why you handle catfish with care. My hand's gonna be swollen again in the morning.
Yeah.
Ow. Alright, so pretty much look, guys. This happened after the catfish stung my finger. I can barely move my hand, and I hooked another catfish. I'm reeling with my pointer finger, that's it.
Try not to get...
Stop it. Record.
It's recording.
Oh my god, this is a big bass. Holy shit. Oh
Jesus Christ!
Oh my god. Oh my god. Alright, so let me tell you a story. It pulled my Shimano Karate in the water. And I'm sitting here casting, looking for it with a topwater popper, because it has a lot of hooks, and a giant hook, and a frog hook. I'm sitting here just dragging this along the bottom.
Holy shit.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Barely hooked.
Barely thing hooked. Is beautiful.
Oh.
God damn!
I'm still really mad my Shimano Karate 200E7 rod and the motor rod just got pulled in water. Let me show you how I hooked this thing. We were sitting here casting this, just dragging it on the bottom, looking for my Karate, because it has a lot of hooks, and put a big old frog hook. And look at this. Oh my god. This is 10 plus pounds. Easy.
Happy?
I'm still really mad I lost my rod. God, we gotta get her unhooked.
Got on a nice size hook.
Golly. This is over 10 pounds. Easy. If you guys saw the picture I posted on my Facebook, this is actually bigger than the one we caught on my Facebook, so. Push a good 10, maybe. 8, 9.
That's nice.
Alright, we're gonna release this big ass bass right here. This big bass. Big bass. She's a giant. She is a pig. After this, I'm gonna go back to looking for my Corrada. So hard as shit. I can't find my crawl. I'm into the bath times. This is my favorite. Like right on the fish.
And that's it.
Alright, so after about an hour and a half of casting with a frog hook, a half ounce or one quarter ounce sinker and a popper, after catching the Debco 33 pole with fish shot, a lamp bang, a bag of gold, toilet paper, I think you see the bar pond. I mean, I found what they call it, a pin. I got the Shimano Corona back. Dirty. Real dirty. There was a giant catfish on the end. It was about 10, 15 pounds. I tried to hand line it in, but it snapped my line. Will not be the final episode of the Bass Times. Better go home. Subscribe, you know what I'm saying? Like the Facebook page. Facebook.com/Bass Times. I'll put it in the description box. Like it, and thanks again for all those reviews.